Small acts, when multiplied by millions of people, can transform the world. Without farmer, there is no food. Before wasting food, think about many without food. With these words, welcome you all to ABS Creations by your educationalist, Chandrakala. Stop wasting food. Try to help others who are in needy. No farmers, no food, no future. So today in this session, we will learn about the major crops of India. So I hope so you have understood the concepts of types of cropping patterns, cropping seasons and the types of farmings in the last session. So now we'll see the types of crops, how the crops have been classified. The crops have been classified into two types. They are the food crops and the cash crops. So food crops are the crops which are useful for edible purpose, whereas cash crops are the crops which are useful for commercial purposes, that is for selling the crops and earning the money. So when we speak about food crops, it can be classified into cereals and pulses. The cereals includes rice, wheat, millets and maize, whereas cash crops include fiber crops such as cotton and jute, plantation crops like tea and coffee, other commercial crops like sugarcane, oil seeds, etc. Horticultural crops include fruits and vegetables and flowers. So these are the different classification of crops such as food crops and the cash crops. Now we'll see about the major food crops of India. First of all, what do you mean by food crops? The crop which is cultivated for edible purposes. They are referred to as food crops. Due to the large population of India, Indian agriculture is largely dominated by the food crops. The percentage of the total cultivated area under food crops has come down since 1950 to 51, but it is still the predominant group with a coverage of over 70%. Food crops include cereals and pulses, amongst which rice, wheat, jowar, bajra, maize, barley, ragi, gram and tur are most important food crops. The first major food crop of India is rice. Rice is also called as a paddy. Rice is mainly a tropical crop, and India, with its tropical monsoon climate, is ideally suited for growing rice. As India is ideally suited for growing rice, India stands second largest producer in the world after China. So this most important food grain is the staple food of a vast majority of people in the eastern and the southern parts of our country. It occupies about a quarter of the total cultivated area in a country. So this staple food crop of India is also considered as a kharif crop, an indigenous crop. So this kharif crop thrives well in the hot and the humid climatic condition. It requires a high temperature of about 25 degrees Celsius and a rainfall of about 100 centimeters and above. In the areas of lower rainfall, it can be grown under irrigated conditions. Though it grows on hill slopes too, the best surface is a level one, that is plain, as water can stagnate on it. So what is the soil condition required for this type of soil? So rice grows well on clayey loam and alluvial soils. The cheap labor is required for sowing, irrigating, weeding, harvesting and other processes. So these are the geographical conditions required for the growth of rice. Which are the major areas rice is grown? There are two major areas where the rice is seen in India. They are the plains of northern and northeastern India, coastal regions and the deltaic regions. So now you can see the map here. So the plains of northern India comprises of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal. And the coastal areas and the deltaic regions include coastal districts of Orissa, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. And the northeastern regions include Assam. So these are the areas of north and northeastern India, coastal areas and the deltaic regions where major areas of rice is grown. Whereas in the low rainfall regions, rice is grown with the help of irrigation facilities in the areas of Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh and the parts of Rajasthan. So rice which is grown in the low rainfall areas come under the regions of Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh, parts of Rajasthan. So rice is considered as a kharif crop, tropical crop and the most important staple food crop for the eastern and the southern parts of India. So the next major crop, food crop, or the next major cereal is the wheat. So this wheat acts as a staple food crop of North India. This crop acts as a staple food of North India. So one of the most important cereal crop after rice. So India holds the second most producer, second most cereal crop in India is the wheat, and it holds the third position in the world production of wheat after China and USA. So mostly in which part of India it acts as a staple food means, particularly in northern part as well as the northern northwestern parts of our country. So what type of crop it is? It is a temperate crop. It is a temperate crop as well as it is a rabi crop. So it is what type of crop it is? It is a temperate crop as well as a rabi crop. So why it is a rabi crop? Because this crop is grown in the season of rabi season. Whereas this region, staple food crop of North India, it lies in the temperate zone, so it acts as a temperate crop. What are the geographical conditions required for this crop? So during the sowing period, the temperature condition should be 10 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius. But during the harvesting period, it requires a temperature of about 20 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. It requires a cool, moist climate during the growing season. And warm, dry conditions at the time of ripening, that is bright sunshine. So in which type of soil this type of crop is cultivated is that mostly in the alluvial soil and the black soil. So what are the geographical conditions required for this wheat cultivation? During the sowing period, it requires a temperature of 10 degrees to 15 degrees Celsius. Harvesting period, it requires 20 degrees to 25 degrees Celsius. And the rainfall condition is about 50 to 100 centimeters. So it requires a cool, moist climate during growing season and warm, dry conditions at the type of ripening. So in which type of soil this crop is cultivated? Alluvial soil and the black soil. Now we'll see which are the major areas of wheat. So there are two zones, wheat growing zones in India. They are the Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwest, Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwest, and the black soil region, that is Deccan region. So Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwest and the black soil region in the Deccan. So the major wheat growing areas are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and parts of Madhya Pradesh. So major wheat growing areas are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and parts of Madhya Pradesh. So wheat is a temperate crop, rabi crop and a staple food crop of North India. The next food crop is the millets. The coarse grains like jowar, ragi and bajra are together called as millets. The coarse grains like jowar, ragi and bajra are together called as millets. They are kharif crops and are grown for grain and for fodder. These are hardy plants, resistant to heat and drought. They are also known as dry crops, as they thrive well in regions of inferior soil, low rainfall of 50 cm below and high temperature of about 30 degrees Celsius. though they are of high nutritional value. So millets are dry crops, which are considered as coarse grains with high nutritional value. First we'll see the crop of bajra. So bajra is an indigenous plant of Africa. Bajra is an indigenous plant of Africa. So this bajra is a crop of dry region. At the same time, it is a staple food crop for poor people. So it is also called as a coarse grains, as we have seen in the previous concept. So bajra is a dry crop, coarse grains, and it is a staple food crop for the poor people, and it is considered as the most indigenous plant of Africa. So what are the geographical conditions required for the growth of bajra? So it requires sandy soils for its cultivation, and it is grown in the regions of low rainfall of 50 cm and below, and a high temperature of about 30 degrees Celsius. So it is also called as a food crop for animals. The areas where the bajra is cultivated are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Haryana. So the areas where bajra is cultivated are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Haryana. The next millet is the jowar. So jowar is one of the most important food crop and the area and its production. Jowar stands third the most important food crop under its area and production. It is also called as a rain fed crop. It is also called as what crop? Rain fed crop. It is also a coarse grain. It acts as a fodder crop for animals. So coarse grains, dry crop, rain fed crop, fodder crop for animals. So which areas we can see the cultivation of jowar is that? Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Madhya Pradesh. So areas where jowar is cultivated in India are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Madhya Pradesh. The next millet is ragi. So ragi is the third most important food crop under area and production. So it is also a crop of dry region and coarse grains. So here the soils which is used for cultivation of ragi are red soil, black soil, sandy soil, loamy, shallow black soil. Varieties of soil we can cultivate ragi, which is having a high nutritional value. So which are the areas ragi is cultivated? It is cultivated in the states of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand, and Arunachal Pradesh. So which are the areas where ragi is cultivated? It is cultivated in the regions of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand, and Arunachal Pradesh. The next crop is maize. So maize is considered as a kharif crop, and also it acts as a food and a fodder crop. So maize is a kharif crop, and it acts as a food and a fodder crop. So what is the geographical conditions required for the growth of maize is that it requires a high temperature of around 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. It requires a rainfall of about 60 to 100 centimeters with high humidity. It grows in the regions of old alluvial soil. So the areas where rice is cultivated are Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Madhya Pradesh. So in all these regions, maize is cultivated as a kharif crop. In Bihar, it is also cultivated in the rabi season, so it is also called as rabi crop. It is also called as what crop here? Rabi crop. So the next crop are the pulses. So pulses, they come under the category of the leguminous crops. Pulses are leguminous crops. India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. So here, when we speak about pulses, it acts as a major source of protein. It acts as a major source of protein in the vegetarian diet. So in the areas of dry condition and in the areas of less moisture, pulses are cultivated. So for the growth of pulses, it requires less moisture and it can survive in dry conditions. Which are the various pulses grown in India? They are tur, urad, moong, masoor, peas and gram. So these are the varieties of pulses which are grown in India. Except arar, that is tur. All crops like urad, moong, masoor, peas and gram, they help in restoring the soil by fixing nitrogen from the air. So all the crops except arar, they help in restoring soil fertility by fixing nitrogen from the air. So which are the areas where pulses are grown? So it is seen in the regions of Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Karnataka. So Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Karnataka, pulses are cultivated more in number. They act as a major source of protein in the vegetarian diet. Now we'll see about the cash crops. First of all, what do you mean by cash crops? Crops cultivated for sale, they are termed as cash crops. They are also called as commercial crops. These crops include sugarcane, tobacco, fiber crops like cotton, jute, mesta and oil seeds. The most important cash crop is the sugarcane. Sugarcane is one of the important cash crop of India and is the second largest producer in the world after Brazil. So India is the second largest producer of sugarcane in world after Brazil. So this crop, sugarcane, is considered as a tropical as well as a subtropical crop. It acts as a tropical as well as a subtropical crop and it requires more number of labor from the period of sowing till its harvesting period. So manual labor is required from the sowing period till its harvesting period. So what are the geographical conditions required for the growth of sugarcane is that it requires a temperature of about 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius with a rainfall of about 75 to 100 centimeters. This sugarcane commercial crop or a cash crop is grown on variety of soils like alluvial soil, black soil, etc. So the areas where the sugarcane is cultivated can be of tropical varieties as well as subtropical varieties, since it is considered as a tropical and a subtropical crop. So areas where it is seen or cultivated is that Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh comes under a subtropical crop. Maharashtra, tropical crop. Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, all these, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they come under the category of tropical crops. Bihar, Punjab, Haryana. So these area come under the category of subtropical variety of sugarcane. So the leading producer of sugarcane in India, the first state is Uttar Pradesh. The next crop and a cash crop is the oil seeds. So when we talk about the oil seeds, they are the premier source. They are the premier source of fat in the Indian diet, as derived from number of crops like groundnut, rapeseed, mustard, sesame, linseed, sunflower, castor seed, cotton seed, niger seed, etc. They provide oil and oil cake, which are used for making lubricants, varnish, medicine, perfume, candles, soaps, manure and cattle feed. So here, when we see about the groundnut, India stands the second largest producer of groundnut in the world after China, and groundnut is considered as a kharif crop, and half of the major seeds are seen in the regions of Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu are the leading producer of groundnut. So whereas rapeseed, the third largest producer of after Canada and China. So India stands the third largest producer of rapeseed after Canada and China. Linseed and mustard seed, they are considered as a rabi crop. Sesame is considered as a kharif crop in north and rabi crop in the south. Castor seed acts as both kharif crop as well as rabi crop. So 12% of the cropped area in India, they are under oil seeds. 12% of the cropped area were under the oil seeds. So sugarcane and oil seeds, they come under the category of cash crop. So now we'll move on to the fiber crops of India. So fiber crops are cotton, jute, hemp and the natural silk. The four important major fiber crops which is grown in India are cotton, jute, hemp and natural silk. So the first three crops like cotton, jute and hemp, they have been grown in the soil, whereas the natural silk is obtained from cocoons of the silkworms fed on green leaves, especially mulberry. So rearing of silk from silkworms is known as sericulture. So the most important fiber crops of India are cotton, jute, hemp and the natural silk. So the most important fiber crop of India is the cotton. India, the home of the cotton, has the largest area under cotton in the world, producing about 10% of the total output. So India, the home of cotton, has the largest area under cotton in the world, producing about 10% of the total output. A small shrub that grows 1 to 1.5 meters high produces big yellow flowers which develop into seed pods called balls. The seed inside is surrounded by cotton fiber. So this cotton is a fiber crop and it is called as a king of fibers. So cotton is referred as what? King of fibers, and India stands the second largest producer in the world after China. So it is also a kharif crop. And what is the condition required for the growth of cotton is, it requires a temperature of about 24 degrees Celsius, moderate rainfall of 100 centimeters and 210 frost-free days. The soil required for the growth of cotton is black cotton soil. So where cotton is cultivated in India, the major cotton growing areas in India are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. So these are the areas where cotton is cultivated more in number, and we India produce a short staple cotton and a medium staple cotton. So the next fiber crop is the jute. The next fiber crop is the jute crop. So jute is an important cash crop in the northeastern parts of India. The fibers obtained from the bark of the jute plant was used as a packing material, and hence it came to be known as the brown paper of the wholesale grade. So here jute is considered as a golden fiber. Jute is considered as a golden fiber, and it is also a kharif crop. So what are the geographical conditions required is that about 27 degrees Celsius, temperature of about 27 degrees Celsius, and a rainfall of about 150 centimeter. And the soil condition required is alluvial soil and the deltoic soil. So here the rainfall is required more in number as the process of retting takes place. As the process of retting takes place, that is retting. What do you mean by the word retting? Removal of the stalk from the fiber. That is, you can see in the picture that fiber has been soaked in the water. It will be soaked for 2 to 3 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, and it will be taken out, and the stalk will be removed from the fiber. So that is what we used to say in the process of retting. So which are the areas? So already I told you, the uses are gunny bags. It is used for preparing mats, ropes, yarn, carpet, and other artifacts. The areas where jute is cultivated in India, it is seen in the region of West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha, and Meghalaya. So these are the areas: West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha, and Meghalaya. Next, we'll move on to the plantation crops. When we speak about the plantation crops, two important beverage crops, namely tea and coffee, are cultivated as plantation crops in our country. Natural rubber is also grown in plantations in the southern hills. These are important commodities of trade. The first most important beverage crop of India is tea. The most important beverage crop of India is tea. India has been the largest producer as well as the consumer of black tea in the world. India is the largest producer and the consumer of black tea in the world. Tea plantations provide employment to nearly 1 million persons, 1 million persons directly, and around the same number indirectly in the processing of transport and trade. So that is what tea, it is a labor intensive activity. Why it is called as a labor intensive activity? Tea plantations provide employment to nearly 1 million persons directly and around the same number indirectly in processing, transport, and trade. So thus tea, it is a labor intensive activity. So what are the geographical conditions required for the growth of tea is that it requires a warm, moist climate throughout the year. It requires a warm, moist climate throughout the year. The optimum temperature required for the growing tea is about 25 degrees Celsius, and it requires a well-distributed showers of 150 centimeters and above. It requires a high humidity and heavy dew are favorable conditions. Forest-cleared soils and acidic mountain soils are most suitable for growing tea. The soil should be well drained, and therefore gently sloping land is considered as the best. Cheap and abundant labor for plucking is an essential requirement. So which are the areas where tea is cultivated in India? They are in the regions of Assam, hills of Darjeeling, Jalpaiguri districts, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Meghalaya, Uttarakhand, and Tripura. So these are the areas. Which are the areas? Assam, hills of Darjeeling, Jalpaiguri district, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Himachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Meghalaya, Uttarakhand and Tripura. So tea is one of the most important beverage crop which acts as a labor intensive industry. The next type of beverage crop is the coffee. So coffee is also a beverage crop. Coffee is a beverage crop. So it is the oldest among the plantation crops in India. Day breaks in most South Indian homes with a hot tumbler of coffee. The coffee seeds are obtained from an evergreen bush. So here it also comes under plantation agriculture, beverage crop. And what are the conditions required? Unlike tea, temperature condition required for coffee is around 18 degrees to 28 degrees Celsius. Rainfall is about 150 to 200 centimeters. It cannot withhold sunshine. So it grows in red as well as laterite soils. It grows in red and laterite soil. So which are the areas or the varieties where coffee is cultivated? The variety is Arabica MN, which is introduced in Baba Budan Hills and in the district of Nilgiris, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So which are the coffee growing areas in India? They come under Nilgiris, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So variety that is particularly Arabica variety, which has been introduced from MN. It has been introduced in Baba Budan Hills, which is situated in the region of Karnataka. So the most important beverage crops under plantation agriculture are tea and coffee. And the next type of plantation agriculture is the rubber. So rubber is cultivated in the southern districts of or southern states of India. So it is considered as what? Equatorial crop. It is considered as equatorial crop as well as tropical and subtropical crop. So rubber acts as an industrial raw material. Rubber acts as what? Industrial raw material. So geographical conditions required for rubber is temperature about 25 degrees Celsius, rainfall more than 200 centimeter, and it grows in laterite soil. It is cultivated in laterite soil. So the areas where rubber is grown are in the states of Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Garo Hills of Meghalaya. So areas where rubber is grown or cultivated is that Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Garo Hills of Meghalaya. So plantation crops are tea, coffee and rubber. Among the three crops here, tea and coffee come under beverage crops, whereas rubber is a plantation crop which is cultivated or grown in the southern states of India alone. Next we'll move on to the horticulture. Horticulture refers to the cultivation of fruits, flowers and vegetables. So the art or practice of gardening and cultivating plants and trees, they are referred to as what? Horticulture. So horticulture crop is nothing but the cultivation of fruits, flowers and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables are important supplement to the human diet as they provide essential minerals, vitamins and fibers required for maintaining health. India is in the second position in the production of fruits and vegetables. So in 2008 from onwards, India stands the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world next to China. So India produces 13% of the world's vegetables. The important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomato, brinjal and potato. So important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomato, brinjal and potato. Here we can see the various fruits which are grown in various states of India. Mangoes. The major producers of mangoes are seen in the state of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal. Oranges. Nagpur, Chirapunji of Meghalaya region. Bananas. In the state of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Guava, in the state of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Pineapples, it is grown in the region of Meghalaya. Grapes, it is grown in the region of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra. Apples, pears, apricots and walnuts, they are grown in the region of Himachal Pradesh. So apple is mostly produced in Himachal Pradesh. So production of bananas is mostly concentrated in the regions of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Goa, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Mangoes, it is concentrated in the regions of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. So all these comes up under fruits and vegetables. They come under the category of horticulture crops. I hope so you have understood this concept. Clearly understand this concept and test yourself. Test yourself by reading these questions. Describe favorable conditions for growing rice and wheat. Name the oilseeds produced in India with areas grown. Explain the geographical conditions required for sugarcane and rubber. What are the two important beverage crops in India? State the favorable conditions for their growth. Mention two major producing states of each crop. Give an account of cotton and jute cultivation in India under the following heads: temperature, rainfall and irrigation, soil requirements, two major cotton growing areas. I hope so this video will be useful for you. And in the description box, I have given two videos of agriculture, its farming types, as well as cropping seasons and cropping patterns for your reference. You can view it for the concepts. If you like this video, you can share it, you can subscribe it. Thank you.